When you determine the value displayed on a meter, you must not only read the scale correctly, but you must also be aware of the meter's degree of accuracy. A meter's accuracy is the amount that the actual value may vary above or below the displayed value. Accuracy is represented as a percentage. The lower the percentage value, the more accurate the meter. As we mentioned earlier, analog meters are generally not nearly as accurate as digital meters. Normally, analog meters have accuracy ratings of 2 to 3%. For d'Arsenault movements, 2% accuracy is typical. For analog meters, the degree of accuracy for a specific reading is a percentage of the full-scale value. Let's use an example to see how accuracy affects a value. The reading on this d'Arsenault meter is 4.6 amps. Exactly how precise is this reading? We start with the basic rule for analog meters. Accuracy equals a percentage of the meter's full-scale reading. Since we said the accuracy for d'Arsenault movements is usually 2%, that means 2% of the full-scale reading, which for this meter is 10 amps. 2% of 10 equals 0.2, which means the accuracy of any reading on this scale would be plus or minus 0.2 amps. For our reading of 4.6, then, the actual value could be between 4.4 and 4.8 amps. Since the accuracy of this analog meter is based on a percentage of the full-scale value, the variation of plus or minus 0.2 amps must be calculated for readings anywhere on the scale. If we have a very low reading of 1 amp, for example, a possible variation of 0.2 amps, either above or below 1 amp, means that the actual value can be up to 20% different from the reading. If we have a full-scale reading of 10 amps, however, an accuracy of plus or minus 0.2 means that the actual value can only vary up to 2% from the reading. From this comparison, you can see why, on analog meters, readings should be taken near the highest end of the scale for the greatest degree of accuracy.